Christmas is coming despite everything, despite the war, the crisis, the darkness that envelops us. Christmas is coming, so Merry Christmas to all of you who are our faithful traveling companions in the communion that unites us through the radio, the web, and social media. Communication, when it is good, when it is not fed with fake news, produces these fruits. It weaves communion, builds community, bears witness to the good, the beautiful, the right, and helps us find a glimmer of light even when we seem to see only darkness. Jesus was really born. God became man. Christmas has already come, in a time that is not our own, but was as dark as our own. We should not be afraid, so it is always darkest before the dawn. But good has already triumphed over evil. Seeming fragile, God made himself man and was born as a baby. He has already scattered the proud in their conceit. He has already cast down the mighty from their thrones. He has already lifted up the lowly. As Don Primo Mazzolari, a parish priest, a prophet of the last century, wrote in one of his poems, "If you want him, God is near you. Even if you don't want him, he is close to you. He speaks to you even if you don't speak with him. If you do not love him, he loves you even more. If you are lost, he comes to find you. If you cannot walk, he carries you. If you weep, you are blessed because he comforts you. If you are poor, you have secured the kingdom of heaven. If you are hunger and thirst for the righteousness, you will have your desire satisfied. If you are persecuted for the sake of your righteousness, you can rejoice and exult. This is how your joy enters the world, through a child who has nothing. Joy is made of nothing, because every man who comes into the world comes empty-handed. He walks, works, and suffers with empty hands. He dies and goes away empty-handed." So this is the mystery of Christmas, the mystery of God becoming a man, becoming a child, a defenseless baby. This is the astonishing mystery of a fragile, loving omnipotence which illuminates our frailty with a new light. It transfigured it, transforms it. He came, he comes. And with him comes the joy we are seeking for. So may the good news that we are called to share travel from person to person as something beautiful because it is true, beautiful because it is personally experienced, beautiful because it tells of the beauty of God and of humankind, and because it builds a togetherness, a communion that sweeps away any loneliness. Merry Christmas to all of you.